We want to complete the following table dealing with information about exponential decay functions in the form of f of x equals a times b raised to the power of x, where a would be the initial amount and b, the base, is equal to the decay factor, which is equal to 1 minus r, where r is the decay rate expressed as a decimal. Looking at these first two rows, notice how we're given the decay rate as a percentage. We're going to convert these to decimals and then find the decay factor. So this column here would be r, the decay rate as a decimal. This column here would be b, where b is equal to 1 minus r. So we first want to convert 80% to a decimal. To do this, if we can remember that a percent is a number compared to 100, it makes the conversion fairly straightforward. 18% is equivalent to 18 hundredths, or 18 divided by 100. So to convert a percent to a decimal, we drop the percent sign and divide by 100. But dividing by 100 is equivalent to moving the decimal point to the left two places. Therefore, this is equivalent to 0.18. Of course, we can check this division on the calculator. 18 divided by 100 is 0.18. And therefore, the decay factor, or b, would be equal to 1 minus 0.18, which would be 0.82. Whenever we have an exponential decay, the decay factor, or b, will be less than 1. Next, we have 3.7%. So as a decimal, this would be 3.7 divided by 100. Moving the decimal point to the left two places, we'd have 0.037, or again, we can go ahead and check this if we want. 3.7 divided by 100 is 0.037. And therefore, the decay factor is equal to 1 minus 0.037, which would be equal to 0.963. For the next two rows, we're given the decay rate as a decimal. We want to convert these to percentages, and then once again to find the decay factor. We'll notice how to convert a percent to a decimal. We drop the percent sign and divide it by 100, and therefore to convert a decimal to a percentage, we multiply by 100 and add a percent sign. So 0.12, or 12 hundredths, as a percentage would be 0.12 times 100, which would be 12, or 12%. Notice multiplying by 100 is equivalent to moving the decimal point to the right two places. And now for the decay factor, we'd have 1 minus 0.12, which would be 0.88. Next, we have 0.085. To convert to percentage, we multiply by 100. Or move the decimal point to the right two places, that would give us 8.5%. Of course, we can check this multiplication on the calculator if we wish. Notice how 0.085 times 100 is 8.5, giving us 8.5%. And then for the decay factor, we'd have 1 minus 0.085, which would be 0.915. And now for these last two examples, we're given the decay factor and asked to find the decay rate as a decimal and as a percentage. So there's a couple ways of doing this. We could just ask ourselves, 1 minus what decimal would give us the decay factor of 0.7? Well, 1 minus 0.3 would be equal to 0.7, and therefore r is 0.3 as a decimal. If we need to, we can set this up as an equation, where b is equal to 0.7, and then we have equals 1 minus r. We would subtract 1 on both sides. This would give us negative 0.3 equals negative r, dividing both sides by negative 1, and we have r equals 0.3, which is the decay rate as a decimal. And therefore, as a percentage, with the decimal point to the right two places, this would give us 30%, or 0.3 times 100 equals 30%. And for our last example, we have a decay factor of 0.975, and therefore 1 minus 0.025 would be equal to 0.975. Therefore, the decay rate as a decimal is 0.025. Whereas an equation, we would have 0.975 equals 1 minus r, subtract 1 on both sides. This gives us negative 0.025 equals negative r, and dividing both sides by negative 1 is positive 0.025. And to convert to a percentage, we multiply by 100 or move the decimal point to the right two places, giving us 2.5%. I hope you found this helpful.